Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel Fitness Freak Computer Geek. In the last lecture, we have seen some coding example of function, okay, where I've shown you the codes which I have designed in few lectures ago. I redesigned it using functions, okay. There you have seen some basic codes there. Also, I have told you that in last lecture, we will see more on that code, okay. Let's see how we can modify that code, okay, to make it more user friendly, okay. Most important part of coding is to make a software a user friendly and a more dynamic and more precise way, okay. So in this lecture you will learn how to make a function more user friendly, okay. It will be essential for you, it will be, you know, play very helpful when you design your code, when you do competitive coding on, you know, websites like CodeSafe, HackerEarth and Hackathon, something, okay, some coding website. When you do competitive coding, whatever you learn in this lecture, that will help you, because in those coding platforms, basically we have to design an entire function where we have to make it more user friendly as much as possible and also make it more precise as possible, okay. The program should not be consumed lots of space, okay. Simply stuck should be performed in minimum space, okay. So we're getting it. So now let's begin. Let me show you the can modify that code, okay. So double click on code block now. Now let us open the files that I've saved in the last lecture, okay. You can open your own file. So Control O for opening, okay. Hope you remember it. So what was our file? Our file was function, okay. So let's open it. You know, if you want to save those program which I have code in the last lecture, you can create your own file, okay. It's not mandatory to, you know, every code in a file, okay. You can create your own file for your, you know, future reference, okay. I'm doing in same code because I want to teach you, you know, because but you have to learn. For learning purpose, you must keep in sample as this code, okay. It will be helpful whenever you do something wrong, you can refer it later for correction, okay. So that's why I recommend you to create your new file, okay. Save those file, don't modify the file which whatever I taught you in the last lecture, okay. Just create a new file, just doing it for you teaching purpose, okay. So that it will not take so much time to write the same code, because we are doing some modification on that code, okay, only not writing any new code, okay. So hope you're getting it. So now we have seen that we have designed our code according to user, asking the user to do the job. So now let us design it more. The disadvantage is that, so suppose you want to perform your operation, but so let me just run one more time for you to show you what was this code doing in the last lecture, okay. So just for revision sake, so suppose you want to perform multiplication and we ask user for two number, so you can see that it is just printing the number and then come out of the loop. Suppose the user want to do some more tasks, okay. So he want to perform multiple tasks and he want to perform again and again. For that case, we will also use loops in this case, okay, in this function. And also I will design some user friendly way menu which will be helpful in designing all the codes which if I get time to teach you data structure and algorithms too, okay. So it is better to follow this step, okay. You can create your own step if you want. This is the way I am showing you all, so it is easiest way, so try to follow it, okay. So let me modify the code now. So what can we do now? Let me let the function be remain itself, and just I want to modify here, okay. So if you get, just erase this part, okay. We'll just modify the main function. Before that, let me create a menu option for user, okay. It will help the user to do the task. So suppose int menu, okay, don't pass any argument here, okay. We don't require any argument because we'll be passing the argument from this function to main function, okay. So let me just write what a user want to do. Suppose he have some choice, so what will we do? Firstly, we will provide a list what he have to do. So just make it some user friendly, okay. So how you can do your own modification. I'm just doing it for, you know, for your understanding sake. It's not essential to use these steps, okay. So I'm just making user friendly, nothing more. So now after printing this, so let's ask the user one by one what he want to do. Suppose give the slash n 2 slash n first number what he want to do. Suppose he want to perform addition, so we'll write addition. Okay, so you can see, you will understand it, usefulness of function in this lecture. Okay, so just copy it and paste it three times. Okay, 1 2 3 4 for addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Okay, you can also add your own number. Okay, if you want, you can also add your own operation, whatever you want to perform, subtraction, then do multiplication. Then suppose you want to perform division now. Okay, so now after printing this, print this part again. Okay, just print it again, so it will come under one menu now. And after that, just take the input from the user, what choice he want to perform. Now notice that I am using integer type here. Okay, in the last lecture I use character base. Okay, plus minus subtract. So in this case, just I will, for sake of understanding, I am using just integer type. So enter your choice. Okay, so suppose give him option what you want to perform from 1 to 10, 1 to 5. Okay, so also let me just change its value to, for cases sake, because I will, and also give one more case of exit. Okay, because we are not designing infinite loop program. Okay, because we want to perform the operation again and again, so we have to provide some exit statement to user also. Just provide it. So just provide option of exit to avoid stucking in infinite loop. Exit, suppose you want to exit. So before and after that, you can also ask the user. Following are the operation based, choose whatever you like. Okay, suppose choose what you want to do, choose one. Okay, so just right, or user friendly way. Okay, so you will choose it. So after choosing it, so following an information, and just don't, it will not more useful. I'm just trying to make it user friendly. So it will print that following are the, following are the operation list. Okay, so after that, you will provide the operation list. Then we ask the user to enter his choice. Okay, so then we will store the choice in where, choice variable. Okay, hope you're getting scanf. Sorry, see scanf. So after percentile, so store the variable in choice, and then return that choice. Okay, to the switch case statement, return choice. So now let me show you what I have done here. In this function, I am just creating a menu for user friendly way to ask the user to whatever he want to do. Okay, so whenever he entered his choice, we will perform the operation accordingly. Okay, so now what we need here, okay, in main function, we will needing the two variables here. Okay, now you can see it here that how function making our code interactive. A person provide us a way to write our program in more effective way and efficient way also. You can see that all the statements are minimized, and we can reuse the code. That is the main purpose of function. We can reuse it again and again, whenever you like. Okay, so that's what I was trying to say here. Now you can get some usage of function that I have explained to you in theoretical lecture. Okay, so hope you are getting it. So what we'll do now, we just need those two variables. Okay, int a, b. Okay, so we will not ask the choice here. Why? Because suppose he enter choice 5, so after the choice 5, it will again ask the value of a and b. So we don't want to do that. We just want it whenever the user want to perform an expert, then only the ask the value from the user, then perform the restrictive functions. Okay, hope you are getting it. So we'll not ask here, we'll just directly begin our switch statement, switch block, and we just get the value what will menu function will return, okay, and do accordingly then. Hope you're getting it now. So what will the case one? Case one is addition. So in this case we will ask the user printf enter the values of A and B. So we will store it in A and B variable. Okay. So just scanf, use scanf. Store it in A and B. And also use 2% LD, okay, because we are using two variable now. So hope you are getting it, okay, what I'm trying to say here. So you can use nested, you know, switch case here, okay. So but it will be, you know, more tedious to do that. So let me just keep it simple now. And also what will you do then? Then we will call the function and do our operation. Okay. So what we want to do actually, we want to perform the summation. So we'll call the sum function and we'll return the value what sum function will return. So we'll just pass this value A and B and it will, you know, return some value which will be catched by this percentile D and this printf will print that function, okay. And also never forget to use the break here. So let me just copy it because we are doing all the four cases will be somewhat similar. So just to save the time I'm doing it. Okay, so printf entered a value and it will remain same, just change the function here. Nothing we have to do as sub. It was sub or not? It was sub. SUV, okay. Just check the number, okay. I have told you about this. So what will be the third case now? So third case is what? Product. So called the pro function. Okay, so we are getting even not changing the variable, just calling the function here. Okay, so it is very easier to write here. Control V. So whatever we want to do now. So we want to perform a division. So div was the function. And also change the cases here, okay, or it will be identical if you are getting it. And it will not run that code. Okay, it will show error. And also use the, you know, case 5. What is the case 5 here? Which is exist. Okay, just exist from the function. So it is another type of, you know, break and continue type statement. And now in the case of break, you have seen that it just take us from the most neighboring, you know, closing bracket. But exit will what do? It will just terminate the entire program here. Okay, so break used to terminate one block, but you know, exit will here terminate the entire program. Okay, so we want to entire, because we will be using this, you know, in a infinite loop. That is, I will show you that. And after that, and we, if you don't provide the exit condition there, it will run endlessly there. Okay, so to just come out of the loop, we just use exit here. So remember that exit function call, you know, exit function, it is a part of header file conio.h. So include that file. Okay, you have to remember this type. Okay, it will come from practice. Conio.h get, and it is present in actually std lib.h. okay, and we will use getcs also. I will show you what getcs do. So just include it, include the conio.h. okay, so you can see that how I am using this. So std lib will contain the definition of exit function call. Okay, so now what we want to do now, it's a very important code. Okay, so listen, watch it very carefully. And what we did another case, we don't use, remember that, notice that I don't use, you know, a break here. Why? Because it will all automatically make us terminate that code. So no need of using a break will be redundant in this case, because we don't want to get out of the block. We just in this case now we want to get out from the entire program. Okay, so we are getting it. So what will the default case here? Default case is printf wrong operation and break it. Okay, slash n wrong operation and just break it. Okay, so you will see that using of infinite loop will be how much effectiveness of using infinite loop here. Okay, so whatever we want to do now, so we just put this entire thing in a switch case in a infinite block. Okay, so just copy this, cut this string and just create now infinite. I've told you that if you return something expression in while function in the expression part, if you return something which will always remain true, then this will the case of infinite loop. So while one, because one is always remain true, so I pass one, you can pass 2, 3, whatever you want. Okay, and so you know that while value is accept boolean value, expression of while value contain a boolean value, this is 0, 1, 0, 4 false and none other zero other than 0 which will treated as 1. Okay, so whatever you print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all the integer, all the value will treated as, you know, true value, except you don't use 0 here, because 0 will consider while loop will consider 0 as a false statement, false expression. Okay, hope you are getting it. I've explained you in the while lectures itself. Okay, so what we did was now put this entire thing in a infinite loop. So now our code is complete. So you can see that one more thing have to be done. So I will show you what uses after running this code. Okay, so let me just run it now. Hope there are no error. Yeah, there is error. Okay, division is, you know, now you are using std lib, it contain division as other file, so just use divi, it has some role. Okay, it is your defined function, so just change it, save it and run it. Okay, so you can see our list is ready now. You can see it is already being printed because we called this function and it will in the switch case itself, so you will print a value, and whenever the choice and function whatever the value we will return according to those value will do our operation. Okay, so you can see this is the way you can design in most graphical way. Okay, so you can see here something designing kind of thing. Okay, so this is the way you can design your menu. Okay, so let me, if you want to do addition, so suppose we enter the choice 1, so it will ask the value for a and b. So suppose I enter 2 and 3, it will enter 5. Okay, so suppose now we want to exit, so we just press 5. Okay, so you can see that now I exit from this block. Okay, hope you are getting it now. So let me do you one more thing. So we don't need conio.h. okay, so it is working without, it is working fine without using, you know, get cs. So let us, you know, do the clr scr also. So is it working, is it still valid in this new compiler or not? Let me see that clr scr, it work perfectly fine in, you know, in Turbo C compiler. So let me just see, does not pop an error. Okay, so undefined symbol, so clr scr are not using, you know, in our compiler, so don't use it. Okay, we don't need it also. So you can see that it is being working without using a get cs also. In a Turbo C, you know, to hold the screen we use get cs there. Okay, so I think it's become obsolete now in our latest edition, so just remove this file, we don't need it. Okay, so now save it and run it. Okay, so what you want to do now, let me just modify one more thing. Okay, so I just want some message, print message accordingly something. So we will, suppose we will want to print whatever one want to place sum. So this is our sum. So again watch it what I am doing here. Okay, we just want to print some message here. DWFRENC, so make it more user friendly. Difference / n product. So what is your quotient? Or you can see just print result divided value, just print it like this. Okay, so let's see what will happen. What will do this? Save it, run it. So suppose now we want perform multiplication now. Okay, so we now enter the value of a and b. So suppose we enter 2, 5. Okay, so let's see, the product is 10. Okay, so just exit from this loop, enter 5 will exit, and whatever we want to do. Okay, so I just forgot to put this signs. Okay, and also after the value of ab, just put something. After that, what will you do? You know, you just modified it everywhere. So save it, run it. Okay, so suppose you want to perform addition now. So what will I enter the value of a and b? So 2 and 4 is 6. Okay, so suppose we want to perform now subtraction. So a and b value, suppose put 4 and 5, it will return -1. You can see it returning -1. Okay, so now suppose we want to perform multiplication. What we want to multiply 5 and 6, product value is 30. Okay, now suppose you want to perform division, so enter the value something like that, 27 9. Okay, so you can see the value is 3. So you can see that it is running for infinite time. Whenever you until you hit this function exit call, so until you hit this, you know, choice number 5, it is working, you know, like infinite loop. It is every time asking the value and doing accordingly. So you can see here, you know, dynamic nature of this code here. Okay, you can understand the dynamic nature here. So it is working according to user friendly way. Okay, so suppose we want to perform division. Suppose we wanted something which is not in the code. Suppose we have designed 5 cases there. So suppose we entered 7 there. What will happen? So it will say wrong operation, and will again restart the code here. So unless you press this, you know, hit reach this condition, it will forever, it the loop will remain forever true, and it will do your job infinite time, for infinite time. So just press 5 now. Okay, so you can see where exists from the function, and return value 0. So you have defined the value 0 here. Okay, if you remember that. Okay, so this is the code of designing our menu function and make it user more user friendly. So let me show you one more code. Okay, so suppose we want to find a maximum of 2 number. Okay, so how we'll write that code. Okay, so just erase this function, we don't need it now. Okay, you can erase it or you can let it be there. Okay, because suppose we want to perform and to compare now 2 number. Okay, so we can design it using the same code here. So okay, so let me just let it be there, and suppose now max function integer. So max have already some user defined things. So max func, write it in max bell. Suppose max bell, suppose we renamed version max bell, and we pass just 2 value, int a comma int b. Okay, so you can design, so you can also see that we according to this code we can modify our code as many times is like. Okay, so it's no any hard fast rule that we have to now erase all the code. You can just append new function, new thing, whatever we want to perform in the same thing, and just listed it in the menu function. Okay, it will do their job. So you can now see that the usefulness of function here. Hope you are getting it now. So whatever, what will you do now? So if a is greater than b, then what? Return a, else return b. Okay, so it is used to design two or more variable, compare two or more variable. So you can use it here, just put one more, just give it one more choice and 5. Okay, just appending the thing here. Okay, no need of writing the entire code here. You can see that this is the usefulness of, you know, versatile nature of the function. You can say that. So just add one more case, copy these things. See how easily I can debugging my code here. Okay, you can see it or modifying the code, our code here. So just do it. Dividend value, not maximum value. Now maximum value, max value. So just remove this thing, it's not look good. So just yeah, okay, so now save it, run it. So now you can see that, okay, I didn't modify the name here. Okay, so you can see 2x division there, sorry. So just maximum value. So you can see how I am designing function. Okay, just I have to modify it. Okay, so now everything looks good. So just whatever you want to do, suppose you want to find the maximum value, so print entered 5. So now suppose we want to compare 8 and 9. So you can see the max value. Okay, some error has happened. I'm calling the division function here. Okay, sorry. I can see that. What was the name of the function? Maxwell. Okay, so you can see that we're getting some error there. Okay, so we just use the divi function twice. Okay, you have to use this function. Okay, you are getting the error. Some of you might have get that error. Okay, earlier while copying. So one thing you remember from a mistake, that while copying and pasting the code, you must change the value according to your need. Okay, otherwise it will give some arbitrary value or ambiguous value, the undesired value, which you don't want to print it here. So what, like you said, that it was returning 0 because it was calling a division function here, and it was performing integer division with 8 and 9. So 8 divided by 9 will return 0. Okay, so you're getting it. So try to debug your own code and try to find the error by yourself and try to solve this code. It will enhance your coding skill. Okay, this is the only way to doing it. Don't follow the shortcuts like learn coding in 5 minutes, don't watch the lecture. Okay, hope you're getting it trying to say here. So now just run it. So now suppose we want to perform finding max to value. So suppose I'm like 7 and 9, so it should return 9. Okay, so you can see that our now function is working perfectly fine. Okay, so now moving on. So let us just exit from this loop. So use 6. So okay, so now you have understand it, how the usage of function via this code. Okay, hope you get it. Last lecture I have also shown you some different type of function, how you can modify it. You can pass argument, we may not pass any argument to the function. You may not you may define the return value or you may not define the return value. Okay, so you can do anything you want according to your need. Okay, so hope you're getting it. So please practice this code more and more, and practice all the other course also. I am shown you another lecture, and try to design your own function and try to do the your specific stuff. So now on, I should terminate the lecture here. Okay, hope, because I think I have explained all the things what could be explained and about the function. Okay, so if you have any doubt, if you still have any doubt, please ask me in the comment section. And if you want me to code some more code, drop that in the comment section. Okay, I will write the code myself if I get time. So I think it's over now. Let me just cut it. So thanks for watching. Hope I have explained you the function well. And you know, from next lecture I will just give you some brief introduction about scope value. What are scope values? Okay, like static function or different type of variables, also static variable, global variable, local variable. I will just do this two to three lecture more with coding, obviously with more coding examples too, along with the theoretical part. And after that I will teach you arrays, which will be very very essential part. Mostly arrays come under, you know, in data structure, but I will teach you here because it will have some usage in pointers. Okay, when we will discuss pointer. Okay, so after array we will cover the pointers. Okay, so thanks for watching, see you soon.